Here are 30 things that you need to know by the time you turn 30.
So whether you're younger or older, here are 30 pieces of advice for your adult life. Point number one, everybody's life moves at a different pace because everybody was dealt a different set of cards. Nowadays with social media, it is so easy to compare yourself to those around you, whether it's getting married, moving to a new city, settling into your career, getting a dog. But remember guys, comparison is the thief of joy.
They're on their third kid already? I don't even have a dog. I don't even have plants yet. What am I doing?
Dang, he already sold the second app already? I didn't even start my first one. I mean, I'm going to. I'm just waiting on the developer and funding, and I'm planning on it. I'm going to do it. You know what?
Dude, they got married and divorced already? I'm still getting ghosted on Hinge.
Number two, definitely start to think about how to invest your money. Now, there's so many different philosophies on how to invest and how much time you want to put into it and your risk tolerance, but those are questions that you have to answer. But let me tell you this, I mean, we're a little bit late on the boat on investing our money, but man, I wish I did it earlier. A risky style.
I'm all into crypto.
A really safe style.
I'm buying bonds and maybe investing in the indexes.
I mean, for a long time, I think people thought that investing was for people who kind of look like Warren Buffett, but nowadays there are so many resources to teach everybody on how to start. You know what? Don't just listen to me, but look it up yourself.
Everybody has their own unique set of metrics for what is success to them. Yes, society does have a conventional set of metrics. Your parents, for sure, they have their own set, but you're ultimately gonna need to decide what's success to your own set of standards. Is it all about money? Because they're sad billionaires. Is life about being lit? Because you can come home from the party which you had fun at and then still be sad.
Listen, at the end of the day, people are built different. You wouldn't judge a bird on its ability to swim, and you wouldn't judge a panda on its ability to hunt down other animals. I'm not gonna judge a school teacher on how much profit they drove, but I'm also not gonna judge a hedge fund manager on how many kids they taught. Usually those types of people in those two professions have different value systems.
Number four, stop drinking bull. Guys, listen, you know what substances affect your body in what way, because you've got things to do, so you better act accordingly.
Dude, I knew I shouldn't have mixed cognac, tequila, vodka, and whiskey together. Then I ate like four pizzas. Now I'm fat. I should have just had a White Claw.
You knew what was gonna happen. Come on, you're way too old to not know that was gonna happen.
Number five, make sure you forgive yourself first. Listen, there's gonna be people out there that won't forgive you for the things you did or did not do. Maybe you didn't help a friend out in need. Maybe you made a bad financial decision that kind of hurt some people. Listen, whatever it is, you have to forgive yourself first and then learn from it and move on with your life. I'll forgive you if you can forgive me, but I'm you and you're me. Number six, stop imagining how great other people's lives are based on what you see on social media. Because yes, they might have nicer material things than you, but trust me, life is really not about that. Plus, you're actually not following them through their day-to-day life. You don't actually know what they're going through. Maybe they live in a constant state of despair because they're not doing anything with their lives, and maybe they have trouble with their family. I mean, the bottom line is that you just don't know. And on social media, you are seeing their highlights and comparing them to your lowlights. Instagram is gonna make you focus on what type of car they're driving, where they're eating, what type of clothes they're seeing, if they're getting reposted by influencers, but really it's all about if you are fulfilling what you're meant to do.
Number seven, make sure you live in near proximity to the things that make you happy. Trust me guys, I've lived right across the street from my favorite gym and I've lived a mile away. Now a mile doesn't really seem that far, but honestly, you had to take the car up this ramp and take this weird left, and it really actually ended up low-key affecting my quality of life. You know, I was gonna go to the gym today, but I just added like 3, 4, 5 extra mini steps to my whole process, so I don't know, I'll just be lazy. It's okay to seek convenience sometimes. It makes sense because it'll make your life easier.
Number eight, stop reliving regrets constantly in your brain. It is tiring. I'm not gonna say don't regret anything in life, but really save it for a few things. And definitely do not regret things that you were not even close to doing. Be real with yourself. Oh, you regret getting into Bitcoin, but you didn't know what Bitcoin was. You regret not starting that YouTube channel earlier, but you didn't even have a YouTube account. Okay, but maybe that guy who bought pizza with what is now worth $100 million in Bitcoin, maybe he might regret it or not, because if he does regret it, he's gonna feel really bad for the rest of his life. So save your regrets, trust me. You don't wanna regret everything.
Be fearless and reckless if that's who you are. Be stable and safe if that's who you are. It's really important to know yourself and to be that.
you know, on the memes and stuff online, it's always telling you to just be reckless and crazy, but that's not really in my personality set. What should I do?
Well, to be honest, to be successful, you sort of need a balance. So why don't you partner with somebody who is fearless and reckless, keep them alive, and then they'll take you to places that you've never been before. It'll be a great complementary team.
Number 10, don't settle. You're not the only one trying to figure it out. The average age of the millionaire in America is 62, and they probably got there through low and slow investing. And we always hear about the young people who got really successful through some combination of luck, skill, and timing, but that's not most people, and that's maybe not your path. That's like saying I didn't become Rice Gum or Vanoss Gaming, or I wasn't born as Ryan's Toy Reviews, so I'm just gonna quit YouTube. I'm not gonna quit, and you shouldn't either.
Number 11, find the right people. Now this goes for romantic partners, business partners, groups of friends, therapists. You gotta find the right people because the people that are surrounding you can really change your life significantly for better or for worse.
I have a group of friends right now, but they're not that good to me, but they're not that bad to me, so I don't know if I'm gonna change. But what if you found like a new group that might be better for you? Well, it seems like a lot of work, a lot of risk, I don't know, you know, I'm kinda scared. Well, then you're just gonna kinda get whatever life gives you, so you can't complain.
Number 12, take care of your teeth. Now, I know this is a really random point, but listen, honestly, bad ortho and bad dentist or no dentist and ortho work when you're younger can really set you down the wrong path when you're older because things only get worse. Plus, you only have one set of teeth. Luckily, with new technology now, you can get, you know, treatment and everything. But trust me, just avoid all that. Take care of your teeth. I don't know if you guys have been on Instagram lately. You've probably seen those ceramic veneers that everybody has. It's like putting an iPhone case that looks like an iPhone on your old iPhone.
Number 13, surround yourself with smart people who have common interests, who like you. I think that that's a really key point because when I was growing up, I would meet people that were really successful, but at the end of the day, we didn't relate to each other, so it was hard to learn anything or feel any connection. For me, like 85% of the successful people that I know, me and them have connected over basketball. If we hoop, then give me the scoop.
Number 14, not every city is the same and sometimes you need a change. Maybe you've spent your whole life in an area and you kind of grew out of it, or maybe some things changed. Maybe you had a long-term breakup and you need a change of scenery. Listen, every city and environment has its pros and cons. I'm a little fish in a big pond.
Well, I seem to be a big fish in a little pond, but at least I know what fish I am.
Either fish is fine, just as long as you know what fish you are and what pond you're in.
Number 15, guys, try to rank things into low, middle, high. And then within those things, you can do another low, middle, high. So that's 3 times 3. Anyway, it's the law of thirds. Pop up the 9 boxes. One thing I do not like about the 0 to 10 ranking system is that it's not nuanced enough. You know how they rank cars as best in class? That's actually the only logical way to rank things. Or even when it comes to a value proposition, sometimes people say, oh man, that thing's so expensive. But if it's a high tier product for a high tier price, it's actually totally logical. For example, if I were to realistically rank how well known the Fun Bros are, I've got to go low, middle, high, and probably say it's the highest of the low, 3 out of 9.
Make sure 2 of the 9 pinned threads in your iMessage are either your parents or family, and also FaceTime with them more. No, Mom, I don't think I'm going back to grad school. But anyways, good FaceTiming.
Number 17, plant a solid tree trunk, especially if you're doing anything entrepreneurial. I see this with young people all the time. There is such a strong desire to plant so many different trees. Your mind is going in so many different directions. Now, I'm not saying there is a 0% chance that that strategy is gonna work, but more than likely, you are spreading your trees too thin. It is better to focus on one very solid red oak of a tree trunk and let the branches diversify out of that.
Dude, I got this sick idea for this clothing line. It's gonna be like for everybody. Like everybody's gonna wear it. It doesn't even matter like what your style is. It's gonna appeal to you. And that way I'll make so much money because like the market is so huge.
I got this idea for this restaurant. We're gonna like cook everything for everybody. The market size is gigantic. Listen, guys, when you are starting off small, especially when you do not have unlimited capital or just a very small seed to start with, you do not want to start competing with the $1 trillion companies.
Number 18, read books, or at least go on those summary apps that will like give you the gist of the book for you. I'm having trouble having smart conversations with the people around me. Well, read the summary of like 100 smart books, or at least listen to them, or something.
Number 19, cut the toxic people out of your life. You know, sometimes you gotta just cut the fat, and you're not hoping that that fat falls by the wayside and has a terrible life, but it's just not fit for what you're doing. That's from your old self, and you're trying to elevate to your new self.
Listen, man, you always have a negative attitude. You never say anything cool. You're really not that helpful, and you don't know how to talk to people. I gotta let you go, man. Number 20, if you're thinking about buying some property, think about buying an investment property. So if you're 30 and you've been working and saving, you're probably thinking about buying a house or condo, but what if you bought an investment property in an upcoming neighborhood? Not necessarily a place you wanna live, but you can rent it out and you're gonna get passive income from that. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't done it yet, but there's a lot of videos on YouTube about it.
Number 21, when you travel, travel with a purpose. Looking at the way millennials are spending on travel, I don't think that I need to tell you to travel. You're probably already doing it. But one thing I will tell you to do is to travel with a project in mind. Whether you're taking a class, engaging with locals, leaving a long-lasting positive impact, volunteering, or simply even vlogging. If you vlog wherever you are, that will create a lot of interaction, pings, and memories that you otherwise would not get if you're just passively hitting up the tourist attractions.
So my last trip to Bali, I didn't just buy a bunch of coconuts from this guy. What I did is I spent 10 minutes to design him a new logo, which he uses to this day. Such a great memory. Number 22, find the experts that relate to you in your own life, because not every success guru out there on Instagram or every book that you read is really gonna hit home with you, because your life is so unique. So if you can find somebody in your community that you kind of relate to, you can feed off that so much more. And if you can't find any models that actually really relate to you, then just take what you can learn from the other gurus and stuff and just apply it for your own life.
Number 23, do not try to keep up with the Joneses. But if you do absolutely have to keep up with the Joneses, make sure you buy something that you can resell at a good price.
Number 24, a lot of the great quotes online that are circulating around the internet come with some prerequisites. Take this famous Steve Jobs quote about following your heart. It sounds really nice, but it's really intended for a certain audience. This quote was actually intended for somebody who was really smart, super hardworking, but just a little bit too scared to break off from the company to do their own thing. Now, if you're not that type of person, it can still apply to you and help you out, but it can also help validate some bad behavior.
Dude, after reading that Steve Jobs quote, I'm just gonna follow my heart, man. I'm following it.
So what's in your heart?
Yeah, just like toxicity, man. That's all. I'm just following that, man. That's what's in my heart.
Number 25, every day you start off your day with a finite amount of energy. You start off with a full pitcher of water and you decide where you want to pour that into different cups. Similarly, your entire life is made up of like different coins. Imagine if every year of your life was one coin. Now you get to decide where you want to spend the coins, but spend wisely. Listen, guys, everybody since they were born has been constantly told you only have one life to live, make the most of it, YOLO. But until you actually have a visual representation, like these infographics or pictures, sometimes it's harder to understand. If you want to spend 5 coins out of your 80 coins of life, just maybe playing games and being negative, you can, but you're not getting those coins back.
Number 26, make sure you get decent sleep. I don't really need to explain the science behind it, guys. I mean, there's a whole new sleep industry with sleep pillows, sleep buds, sleep aids, sleep mattresses. I mean, to be honest, older people just have less energy. That's just a fact. So just make sure you get decent sleep. Number 27, buy a good version of the product you use every day. I'm not saying everything has to be nice. You're okay, your car and your phone and your apartment or house doesn't have to be super expensive, but make one of those things high quality, because the things that you use every day, it touches your life differently. Number 28, as you get older, you probably won't see your friends as often, but that's okay, because it's more about quality than quantity. Here's a little easy, quick tip for maintaining important relationships. I mean, just find an article or find some type of forum or thread that relates to everybody and then send it in the group thread. And at least that lets everybody know that you're thinking about them. Plus, you guys can have a conversation about it too. Number 29, you should start being able to identify what type of partner you want to be with. I'm not telling you to settle down at all, but by 30, you should probably have an idea of, you know, the type of traits in a person you enjoy being around.
Well, I clearly had no idea that pursuing this Instagram model wasn't gonna work out. I'm flabbergasted.
And last for number 30, this might be one of the most important ones, is that ideas are easy to come by, but the execution is the hard part. Guys, I know that we've all thrown around ideas with our friends back and forth. Oh, that sounds sick. Oh, that's a great idea for a business. But listen, getting started is literally like the hardest thing. So get it started first and then make adjustments along the way. A lot of people have come up to us saying, hey guys, how do I start a YouTube channel or how do I start my Instagram brand? I'm like, well, do you have a YouTube channel yet? Do you have an Instagram brand yet? I mean, just get it started and think about how to improve it along the way. Trust me, starting a YouTube channel is probably one of the easier entrepreneurial things you can do. It's free, it's quick. I mean, just start it.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching that video about 30 pieces of advice before you turn 30. Whether you are going to turn 30 or you're past 30 and it was great to hear a reminder, make sure you let us know in the comment section below any additional pieces of advice that you might have.
All right, everybody, so make sure you hit that like button and share it with anybody who needs to hear it. We just wanted to put together a list that will help you personally or help the world. I mean, you know, this is just from our experience. So thanks again for watching, and until next time, we out.
Peace.
I'm a little fish in a big pond.
I'm a big fish in a little pond. I'm a big fish in a little pond.
I'm a big...